like to see them dead. That was 4 weeks ago. Well, big five.
Pick it up and put it in your pocket, or somebody else just
I've never done before. What could I do that I haven't done? I don't know. Something probably that I wouldn't talk about in open company. Madonna horror syndrome. I'm not necessarily pointing towards Pietro over here to say that. Sorry. Where's my manager? Tell me what to say. I don't know. No, this one's called Can't Stop the Show. It's about a guy in the East Coast.
Thank you.
good when you cheat. And I've told you time and time before, you're a showgirl, not a whore. Jack picked up the phone, is it those jerks again? You think they know by now that these girls, they just dance and grin. Just good, clean entertainment. We don't handle the tricky business in here. The curtains go up and both lights go on. And Betsy's out there in her birthday suit, spinning her baton. But I think she did it better last year. you'll know whose blackboard lacks a piece of chalk.
Battle stance, and I wondered how the bullets missed this man.
was gone. When I got back to my HQ, I told them about my night at the battle I'd spent with a big marine in camouflage. When I said his name, a soldier gulped, and a medic took my arm and led me to a green tent on the right. Said, you may be telling true, boy, but this here is camouflage, and he's been right here since he passed away last night. Save a young marine caught in a barrage. So here, take his dog tag, son, and we want you to have it now. And we both said a prayer for a big marine and count on. Or hear a voice that in your mind will honor. Just be thankful that you're not alone and you got some comfort.
Shook her hand, and I said, okay.
I hear a clock and I get up fast and draw the curtain on a brand new day. I can't wait to get this cast off. The telephone's dead. I guess they turned it off today. Turn the key on the mailbox slot. I'm looking for a letter, but bills is all I've got. And even the cat she left me with is going out with someone else. So put another quarter in the jukebox, Pete, but don't play that one with the sad trombone, 'cause tonight I'll be walking home. Search of the Last Honest Man. This is probably a very good patriotic number, right? Before we do that, though, let's get the spotlight down here and pan the audience for some celebrities. I think I see them tonight. There we go. What's that? Who is that? Oliver North's cousin right there. Tell your cousin. I don't know what to say to you. Who's over there? What do we got going over here? That is somebody. No, that is some... Are you shot? No, that's not Sean. No. You're from south of the border, my friend, are you? Are you? Can you say this? Woo! Yeah, see? Oh, you must go down there all the time. Oh, he does have a Mexican accent. He does have. Yeah. Well, this one's for you, my friend, with that hat. All right. I love to dedicate songs. I don't care. I got no shame. Okay, this one's Last Honest Man. Last wind and blow. We've been peeking around. Is everybody, everyone dishonest in this town? The statue in the back, you get a handshake and a smile. One if one don't get you, the other one will. You gotta walk that mile. Looking for an honest man. We're looking for the last honest man. An honest man. He's searching for the last. Behind. It may not make any difference, I don't know. I want to get that fatalist on 4th of July. Yes, do I? Oh, it's a horribly sick world we live in, isn't it? No, it's not that sick. Oh, God, I'm just so, I don't know. Went down there, yeah, play that for me. Did you almost have that piece you play when I'm kind of rambling on and not making any sense? It's your big moment now. That's it. Yeah. That makes me feel. I went down to the beach tonight, you know, and looked it all. Did you guys go down there? I went down there. I was sitting there with some friends of mine, the band and everybody. We started looking at those fireworks and thinking to ourselves, God damn. I remember when we were a lot younger than we are now. It's gotten to that now. It's not like I'm sitting there concentrating on it or anything, you know, but I'm depressed. I mean, I a couple of days ago, I went and I got this haircut. I hate my hair. I know. I went in, I thought I'd try to get it done quickly because it was a painful thing. I hate getting haircuts. It takes a lot of time out of my day. So I thought, super cuts. Why not? $8. They're not, I don't know. I was drawn in. The commercial got me. Come on. It's lopsided, I know. Now I have to get something really radical to like fix it. Of course, I kind of poofed it up before I came out here, but it makes me think of things about, makes me think of expressing my thoughts and feelings to all. And when I think about expressing thoughts and feelings, I think of all of us coming together on this holiday and being closer together, sharing thoughts and feelings with one another, together. Beautiful. Even though it is an old bit. I'll do it anyway. I have no shame. So I want everybody here in this room to look to the person next to them. You may not know them, all right? Look to them and say, knowing that they share thoughts and feelings too. And look to them. Look them straight in the eye and grab them by the hand and say, you are too fucking close to me. Can you move kind of to the side? I can't stand it anymore. There's too many people on the earth. They're all over the place. What's this clown music? This is for the eyes of dogs to come, okay? And Bernard over here. Fairies alone, and then the other dog digs it up and finds a prize in store. One dog dies and the other dogs go dig him up the tomb with his name and scroll. so bold. The words are clear and strong. It says, this one is for the eyes, for the eyes of the other dogs to come. It's for the eyes of the other dogs to come. One man digs a hole and while another one shovels dirt inside another hole. We'll be right back. Point to ugly little lies, hide them in a home chest, in an attic, in Van Nuys. Trusted friendships can go sour, betrayal at the midnight hour. Just remember, I hate the blues. There's something out there.
Street in town where a gray old man looked him up.
band down and said, son, you must be good as Boogie Man Day. You're a long way off from Yippee-Yi-Yay. Cause I can tell at a glance you're not from around these parts. You got a green look about you, and that's a gringo for starts. Sometimes the only thing a Western savage understands are pistol rifles and an unarmed man like you. So you gotta keep on the move. Don't let that fancy paint job fool you. Then the old timer pulled him close and said, by the sound of 6 rounds of light caliber rifle fire, followed minutes later by the booming of 9 rounds of a heavier rifle. But the tank closed off the wilderness. Just then he heard the snick of a rifle bolt, found himself staring down the muzzle of a weapon held by a drunken liquor store owner.
There's a conflict, he said. There's a conflict between land and the people gotta go. Come all the way out here. Maybe like sit on the beach and watch the kind of like smoky Joe house boom in flames. Maybe light themselves on fire every 4th of July. What do I care? Maybe like hang out like go to Supercuts and get a bad haircut. I have the freedom to do that. Why not? Maybe like open up my own haircut place where you get nothing but scalp haircuts. I'll just cut people's heads off. That's what I'll do. Maybe I'm a dark and nasty. I don't know. I'm in a nasty mood. I can't help it. I can't afford to bring gravity. And all the brush of steel, and you'll hear the call of the West, call of the West. You'll hear the call of the West, call of the West. You'll hear the call of the West, call of the West. You'll hear the call of the West, call of the West.
Thank you.
could smell the perfume. It was something I smelled before. I threw up red light while I spilled my drink. I could feel something sticky on the floor. I said, miss, you gotta tell me where you wanna go to. I can't see you driving around the same block. Then she crumpled her cup. I pulled the gum off my shoe. And then she told me, just shut up. Keep your hands on the field. And just ride, she said. It started to rain, so I turned the windshield wipers on full. And on the bag in her lap, I saw the name of a big bank downtown, and I said, you don't have to worry about me, you know. I turned the headlights on, just for a minute. I thought I saw the both of us on some kind of tropical island someplace, walking down a white sandy beach, eating something. She was fixing her hair in the mirror. I made a left turn at a yellow light from my cab. That's for the fear. She boarded the boat and turned and blew me a kiss. And later on, when a squad car came round, I ate a handful of peanuts. Then I told them this. I don't remember much except to keep your hands on the wheel. That's a surprise, she said.
Thank you. a note I received here, a very nice note backstage, and this one is for someone named Cher, okay? This is dedicated to her. This one's called Lost Weekend. It's her birthday. There she is.
In her automobile, she was in the back seat while he was at the wheel with the windows wide open. All the money from the store they gambled away. He said the best laid plans often go astray. Took the page of her book and turned it down. She lit a cigarette, she didn't make a sound. And I know if we had just one more chance, he said, we finally hit a big one at last, she said. Instead of another lost weekend, lost weekend, another lost weekend, lost weekend. Business cleaning swimming pools, she said. Instead of another lost weekend, lost weekend, another lost weekend, lost weekend. Smile.
can stay in. It's up another mile.
Fasten our safety belts. Go out here to LAX and get on a hot rod plane, I think. this time, if I may. Over here on keyboards, Pietro Calhoun. On bass guitar, Joe Ramirez. On drums, Joe Girardi. And on guitar, Greg Aragin. He's our new member, been with us a couple of days, yes. Over here on keyboards, Bernard Hall with his new jacket on. And I'm your host, Glenn Campbell. Thank you. Whatever happened to Glenn? We're gonna try some kind of like, we're gonna go. Where are we going? We're going to what they call the continent, right? The continent. It's not America, it's the European continent. We're going to immerse ourselves in some sort of kind of ridiculous beer hall thing here. And this is a song by Kurt Weill and Bertolt Brecht called the Canon Song, all right? And this was on a record somewhere. This one is dedicated to Klaus Barbie. Done with the pens and the team was all there, and Georgie was up for promotion. Not that the army gave a bugger who they were, but the fronties of he, the commotion. The troops live under the cannon's thunder. From sea to Cooch Bay Harbor, from place to place, when they come face to face with a different breed of fellow, whose skins are black or yellow, they quake as we chop them into beefsteak tartare. Warm and Jimmy found the weather too balmy, but Georgie took them both by the arm and said, "Oh, never disappoint the army." The troops live under the cannon's thunder, from Sin to Cooch Bay Harbor, moving from place to place. When they come face to face with a different breed of fellow, whose skins are black or yellow, they quick as winky chop them into beefsteak tartare. Is dead and Georgie was shot for looting, but young men's blood goes on beet red. Yeah. And the army goes on ahead, recruiting the troops live under. Place to place, when they come face to face with a different breed of fellow, whose skins are black or yellow, they quick as we can chop them into beefsteak tartare. Thank you. You know, while we were driving down here, I fell asleep for a while in the van. And I was thinking of my new guitar player, Greg Aragin, and why... And I was wondering to myself, was I a dream? Was I dreaming or was I awake? I don't know. Was I awake or was it a dream or was it somewhere in between? I couldn't say. But all I knew is that a shape started to appear on the overhead of the van. Started to come together. First it started like a small kind of amoeba, kind of plasma thing, and then it looked a lot like a popsicle after a while. After that it shaped into a human figure. And as it came into shape and I saw what was coming there and focusing in my retina, I knew then that yes indeed, it was the ghost of Elvis Presley. And as he appeared on the overhead, wearing those lame old clothes he wore, he was holding a box of like Eskimo pies and had it all over his face. But he said to me, he said, "Stan, I'm dead and gone now. A long time. I've surveyed the whole planet. There's no one else here more qualified to take my place than you." I said, "No! Whoa!" I said, no, I don't want the job. Then I started thinking about it. And I was thinking about a house and all kind of a, maybe a couple of brunette women with those beehive hairdos to maybe mow my lawn or clip my hedge for me. And I thought to myself, no, I don't want that. But there's one thing he had that I wanted more than anything else.
Bigger ass than me, you rockin' teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck, can't be free anywhere. Oh, let me be
your teddy bear.
Thank you.